When you take a stroll along the riverfront, you never know just what you may find. One family in Illinois found something pretty cool while digging through the sand. Our Steve Harris has their story.
A lot of things went into the Mississippi River during the flood of 1993. But this story is about what came out of the river 26 years later.
I would love to know that jar story.
Well, it's a story that begins at the end. A few weeks ago, 22-year-old Ted Canope found a salsa jar stuck in the sand near the river in Chester, Illinois. Inside the jar, a note. It was a letter from a fifth grade class dated 1993.
93, I was born in 97, so I thought, well, this letter's older than me.
They were able to make out a zip code. Five numbers that led them to the Maud Bishop Elementary School in Topeka, Kansas.
I thought it was amazing.
Meg called the school district and found out that school was no longer there. But when she read the letter to the woman at the office,
got to the bottom and I said, there's two teachers listed here. Can hardly read it, but I started to read. It said Susie, Suzanne, something like that, Weedell, Waddell. And she said, I know her.
If you find this letter, please write us a letter telling us when you found it and where you found it.
Suzette Weedell, a retired Topeka school teacher, was the mind behind the message. It was her fifth grade class who wrote the letter as part of a geography assignment.
We did go to the outlet at Lake Perry and threw the bottle into the river.
The bottle then made its way down nearly 400 miles of winding waterways to Chester.
I couldn't believe it, really. What are the chances of that happening?
The little letter never made it to its intended destination, the Gulf of Mexico. But it did make history in Topeka, Kansas, and Chester, Illinois.
That was our Steve Harris reporting. Stay